गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई माई सेल्फ दिवाकर पांडे फ्रॉम कुंती नगर मॉडर्न इंग्लिश स्कूल नवादा एंड वेलकम टू यू इन योर ई लर्निंग क्लास। टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू माई थर्ड वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ लेसन 7 इन ज्योग्राफी एंड द टॉपिक इज आवर कंट्री इंडिया विच हैज़ बीन टेकन फ्रॉम क्लास 6। इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो एज आई हैव डिस्कस्ड यू अबाउट पॉलिटिकल एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव divisions of our country India, and now in this video today I will discuss you about the physical division of our country. As we know, our country India is symbolized, is marked by a diversity of physical features. There are so many physical objects in our country, such as mountains, plateaus, plains, coasts, and islands. Standing as sentinels in the north are the lofty snow-capped Himalayas. What is the meaning of Himalaya? Now, first of all, we come to know. Him Jod Alaya means the abode of snow. It means Himalaya is the abode of snow. Why? Because it is always capped with snow. The Himalayan mountains are divided into three main parallel ranges. Do you know what are these three parallel ranges? Yes, the northernmost of the Himalayas, it means the northernmost part of the Himalayas, is the Great Himalaya, that is also known as Himadri. It is the world's largest peak. It means the world's largest peak are located in this range. It means in Himadri range. Now we come to know Middle Himalaya. It is the middle part of the Himalaya, that is also called Himachal. It means Middle Himalaya or Himachal are the same name for Himalaya. So Middle Himalaya, it means Himachal, lies to the south of Himadri. Many popular hill stations are located here, and we can also find out their names of 5 hill stations. Now we come to know about the Siwalik. The Siwalik is the southernmost range, that is the third range of Himalaya. Now, after knowing about the Himalayan range, we come to know about the northern Indian plains. What are the northern Indian plains? These plains lie to the south of the Himalayas, and they are generally level and flat. These are formed by the alluvial deposits. Do you know what are alluvial deposits? Yes, alluvial deposits are very fine soils that are brought by rivers and deposited in the river basins. So the northern Indian plains are generally made up of the or formed by the alluvial deposits that are laid down by the rivers, and these rivers are the Indus, the Ganga, and the Brahmaputra, and their tributaries. Do you know what are tributaries? Yes, tributaries are a small rivers or a stream which contributes its water to a main river by discharging it into main river from either side. So these are called tributaries. It means tributaries are the smaller rivers. Now we come to know about these tributaries. So the Indus, the Ganga, and the Brahmaputra and their tributaries help to form the northern Indian plains. These river plains provide fertile land for cultivation. It means cultivation is possible in the northern Indian plains only due to these rivers and their tributaries. That is the reason for high concentration of population in these plains. And this is the reason that people in large number liked to settle in these northern plains of India. Now we come to know in the western part of our country. Yes, in the western part of India lies the Great Indian Desert. So in which part of our country the Great Indian Desert is located? Yes, the Great Indian Desert is located in the western part of our country. Do you know this area is a dry area? It means it is a dry, hot and sandy stretch of land. It has very little vegetation because of sand. Now we come to know about the south of northern plains. To the south of northern plains lies the peninsular plateau. Do you know what is peninsula? Yes, peninsula is the part of land which is surrounded with water on its three sides. So like this, when we study the southern part of northern plains, we can say it is a peninsular plateau, and in size or shape it is triangular. It means it is triangular in its shape. The relief is highly uneven, and this region with numerous hills, ranges and valleys like very beautiful, looks very beautiful. Aravali Hills, which is one of the oldest range of the world. So which range is the oldest range of the world? Aravali Hills is the oldest range of the world. So Aravali Hills border it on the northwest side. The Vindhyas and the Satpuras are the important rains. The rivers Narmada and Tapi flow through these rains. Like this, these are west flowing rivers that drain into the Arabian Sea. So which rivers drain into the Arabian Sea? Narmada and Tapi. Now we come to know about the western ghats or Sahyadris. It means the western ghat and eastern ghats are two ghats. The western ghats, that is also known by the name of Sahyadris, border the plateau in the west, and the eastern ghat provides the eastern boundary. Like this, I have discussed you in my video, and the rest part of this chapter I will discuss in my next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.